Welcome. My name is Marcin Lewandowski, and in this episode of The Viewfinder, I'll invite you to enjoy and explore photographing your own neighborhood. With all these exotic photographs from around the world constantly appearing on our screens, it's sometimes hard to forget that to take interesting pictures, we don't have to leave for faraway places, but just open our eyes and look at what's around us. I know it's sometimes hard to get inspired by seemingly mundane everyday reality, and I'm sometimes guilty of it myself, but let's not forget that some of the greatest American photography and photography tradition in general revolves around that everyday reality. To make things a bit more inspiring, let me mention few American photographers that have masterfully approached photographing what seems like boring everyday life. Starting with something that looks like the easiest idea, Ruth Orkin. She repeatedly photographed the view from her window at different times, sometimes looking in a different direction, sometimes with different focal lengths, but always having the same vantage point. If you prefer to go out, I suggest checking out Stephen Shore's beautifully framed photographs of uneventful situations in a city environment. And I don't want to compare these two photographers, but if this type of photography is down your alley, then check out also color work of William Eggleston. To mention something more practical and easier to pinpoint, why not look at something along the lines of Elliot Erwitt's spectacular collection of dogs? Or something that partially inspired me to do this episode, abstract photographs of ripped posters by New York photographer Aaron Siskind. It's always good to learn from the best, and to find our own topic and style, it's worth wrestling a bit with already tried and tested ideas, tweak them, change to own liking, and reapproach in a more personal way. On one hand, probably everything has been photographed to date, but on the other hand, most of the things were never photographed through your third eye, and that's what's important. When photographing things that we see every day, it's worth trying to mix different approaches. For example, maybe start with photographing all the houses on your street, then change the lens and photograph all the doors of these houses. If you have it in you, photograph all of your neighbors in front or at the back of their houses, or ask them to photograph macro close-ups of their house keys, etc. This way of looking for photographs can be naturally juxtaposed onto your way to work. If traveling by car, photograph at each red light. If by public transport, then document bus stops, or seats in the bus, or train, and. Most of all, make it personal. I hope you enjoyed this episode, subscribe to our channel for more, and if you want to work some more on your skills, check out Adorama Learning Center. This was Marcin Lewandowski for Adorama TV. See you next time.